In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry Free Worksheet Angle Constructions. Now remember, for constructions, all you need is a compass, a straight edge, and a pencil. So for number one, we're to construct a copy of the angle. So we're going to essentially be making a congruent angle. Now in order to do that, remember an angle is formed when two lines or two segments intersect. So we're going to need to start with an end point. And we need to have a line coming out from that endpoint. Now we just need to figure out what angle this other line will be at. And in order to do that, we're going to look at our given angle and copy that. And how we'll do that is we'll take our compass, starting from the vertex, place it anywhere along our original angle where one point is at the vertex and the pencil point is not. Then we're going to make an arc, keeping that same measurement on our compass. We're going to do the same for the segment that we created below. So that point will be our vertex, and we'll make an arc. Now, we're going to use our compass, and on our original angle, the intersection of that arc we created, one intersection will be one point of our compass, and the other intersection we will put with the pencil point of our compass. So copying that distance, we're going to move our compass, not changing the degree of our compass at all, place it on the intersection of the segment we've already drawn, and see where it intersects the arc that we previously created. Now that intersection is going to be a point on the new segment for our angle, and starting at the vertex and drawing a line to connect that point, we will create our congruent angle. So this angle is congruent to this angle. And number two, it says to construct the bisector of each angle. So we want to find the line that bisects this angle, essentially making the angle into two smaller congruent angles. Now in order to do that, we're going to first create an arc. So starting at the vertex of our angle, extending the compass out, we're going to draw an arc. Now from this arc, I can change the measurement of my compass if I want, or I can leave it the same. But coming out from this arc, I'm going to draw an interior arc. Keeping that measurement the same, I'm going to place my compass on the other intersection of the arc that I originally drew. So placing it on the other intersection, I'm going to then see where my new arcs or new marks intersect, and that point will fall on the angle bisector because I kept the compass the same measurement coming from the intersection of my original arc. So I just need to connect that point with my vertex. And there I have my angle bisector. In number three, it asks us to construct an angle whose measure is twice that of the angle given. So we're going to be doubling this angle, or essentially adding it to itself. So remember, we first have to start with a new segment. And this point will be the vertex of our new angle. Now we'll take our compass and draw an arc along our original angle, and we'll draw that same arc, but we'll make it a little bit bigger since we'll be adding the arcs together. So once we draw that original angle, we'll be able to double that on this same arc. So now from the intersection point of the arc on our original angle to the other intersection point, we'll line up our compass. And then from the intersection point of our new segment, we'll make that mark. And remember, we're going to be doubling that angle. So if we were to draw a line now to the intersection, that would be the angle that's congruent to this angle. However, from that new intersection point, we're going to be drawing another mark, and that new intersection will be the doubled angle. So this angle is twice the measure of this angle. And note that this is greater than 90 degrees, so this angle should be greater than that straight line of 180 degrees, and you can see visually that it is indeed. So just making these lines bold for you so you can see the two segments that make up our new angle. And we measured this way, not this way. And number four, it says construct an angle whose measure is equal to the sum of the measure of the angles given. So starting with my line segment, here will be the vertex of that angle. Let's start with the larger angle. So going from the vertex of that angle, I'm going to draw an arc. And using the same measurement, I'm going to put an arc on the smaller angle, and I'm going to put an arc from the vertex that will be my new angle. That way, when I measure the distance between the intersections, I'm going to do it along this same arc. So I don't have to create a new arc once I get one angle. I'll just use the same arc to base my segments off of. So looking at this larger angle first, from one intersection to the next, I'll make that tick mark from the intersection of my new segment to the arc. And then from that intersection point, I'll then measure that smaller angle. So gathering that on my compass, and then from that intersection point to the arc, which falls here. So this angle is the sum of my original angles. And again, I can go directly from this tick mark because the arcs are the same distance from the vertex. Now, number five, it says to construct an angle whose measure is equal to the difference of the measures of the angles given. So we're going to start with the larger angle and subtract this smaller angle. So let's first draw this congruent angle. So here's a new segment to help us start that new angle, which will be the difference. Now from the vertex of each of my angles, I'm going to draw an arc that is the same distance from that vertex. So I'm not going to be changing my compass at all when I move to this next angle and to the angle that I'm going to create. So all those arcs are the same distance from each of the vertex or each of the vertices. Starting with this larger angle, I'm going to look at the intersection that the arc has among each of the segments that form that angle. And then I'll transfer that to help me solve for my new angle. Now that intersection will form a congruent angle. However, I'm subtracting this smaller angle. So I'm going to place the points of my compass on each of those intersections. And then I'm going to be subtracting it. So from that intersection point that would help form that congruent angle will be one point of my compass, and then the pencil point, I will strike a line making a new intersection, which will help form my new angle that is the difference of my given angles. So this intersection was the angle congruent to this first angle, and then this angle was congruent to this angle. So I took away that smaller angle from the larger angle to get my new angle in number five, the angle whose measure is equal to the difference of the given angles. On to the last page, in number six, it tells us to construct an angle of 30 degrees. Now in order to start, we need one segment that will help us form that angle. So the point I created will be the vertex of that angle. Now I'm going to make my compass smaller than the segment that I've drawn, place one point on the point that will become my vertex, and then extend an arc, making sure to intersect my segment I created. Now, from the intersection of the arc I just drew and my segment, I'm going to place one point of my compass and then draw to intersect that arc, making sure to draw a longer extending arc because in my next step, I'm going to place my compass on the new intersection and then draw along that arc to create another intersection. And that last and final intersection will be one point on the other segment that forms my angle of 30 degrees. And there is my 30 degree angle, created using nothing but a compass, a straight edge, and a pencil. Now lastly, number 7, we're going to be constructing a 45 degree angle. But in order to start, we need a segment with an endpoint. And this endpoint will eventually become our vertex of our angle. Now looking at this segment, I'm going to create a line perpendicular. So from the point that will eventually be my vertex, extending, making sure I'm slightly greater than half the distance of the line, I'm going to make my perpendicular bisector. Drawing a tick mark above and below, keeping my compass the same, going to the other endpoint of my segment, above and below. So now I have 2 points of intersection that will help me form a perpendicular line. Now where that perpendicular line intersects my original segment that connects to the point that will eventually be the vertex of my angle, I'm going to measure that distance. Starting from that center point where the perpendicular lines intersect, I'll measure out to the point that will eventually be my vertex, and I can draw an arc until it intersects with my perpendicular bisector. Now my bisector was not quite long enough, so I'll take my straight edge, line it up, and make sure it's long enough. So again, I took my compass, put it on the intersection of my perpendicular lines, measured out to where my vertex is eventually going to be, that end point of my segment, and then drew an arc until it intersected that perpendicular line, and that is one point on the other segment, so I can draw a line connecting my vertex to that point, or my end point to that new point, and that will help form my 45 degree angle. And with that, I'll wrap up this angle construction worksheet. If you have any questions, leave a comment below. And as always, like, subscribe, and share.